Hello, in this video I want to show you how you can discover the value of what you carry, the value of your skill, your knowledge and experience. If you watch to the end of this video, you will discover how important you are, so that you will stop jumping at every business opportunity that is being advertised on Facebook. The day I discovered this key factor, I stopped jumping at every business opportunity. I now knew how important I am, and I know exactly what to do. So make sure you stay to the end of this video so that you can discover how important your knowledge, skill and experience is, and how to get the best out of it. Let's keep the ball rolling. Now, if you look at a key, if you look at the key of your house, it is very small, but the day you lose it, you will know how important it is. So a key is a very small part of a system, which when removed, the system will not work. Everywhere we have keys. In every system we have keys. If you have a laptop and you remove the battery, what will happen to the laptop? The light will go off. It will stop functioning. Until you get that battery, your laptop will not work. If you look at your phone, if the screen of the phone is bad, no matter how beautiful the phone is, it will not work. That means at that particular time, the screen becomes the key. Then, if you have a car and the tire is bad, only one of the tire is bad, it doesn't matter, you can't go anywhere. So that one tire, that only one tire becomes the key to that car at that moment. So if you look at it now, there is a particular system you belong to. And if you are a mechanic, for instance, people may not value you, but the day their car breaks down, that is the day they will start valuing you. Without you, they cannot get out of that place. So at that point, you become a key. Then let's look at it in another direction. Say for instance, you are a bricklayer. People may not value you, they may underrate you, until the day they want to build their house. It doesn't matter the amount of money they have, they don't know how to raise blocks. So until they get a bricklayer, that wall cannot be raised. So at that point, a bricklayer becomes the key to that system. Then let's look at another angle again. Take for instance, you are an architect. Now, people may not value you. Some may say they don't need an architect to produce a drawing for them, so they can call a bricklayer and they will build their house for them. There is another set of people that need an architect, and if a plan is to go for approval in the development control or approval authority does not work without an architectural drawing. A quantity surveyor cannot work without an architectural drawing. So at that point, an architect becomes a key. So none of that particular system cannot work without you. Then let's look at another direction again. If, for instance, you are a tailor, people may not value you until the day they want to sew their clothes. That is the day they will value you, because they can have their money, they go and buy their clothes, they cannot put it together, they cannot design it. So they need a tailor or a fashion designer to create that beautiful cloth, that beautiful attire they need. So at that point, the tailor or the fashion designer becomes the key. Without you, the system cannot work. They cannot get what they want to get. So, with this, I want you to know that you should start valuing yourself. That system, that particular system you belong to, you are very important to that system. The day you are not there, that system will stop working until they look for replacements, or until they look for a spare key. That is another person that can perform the same function that you can perform. Then let's look at it this way again. In a football match, there are two teams, 11 players on each team. Now, if you take one of the team and you remove a goalkeeper, that team will mess up if the goalkeeper is removed. And that means the goalkeeper becomes the key at that particular point. So that means everywhere there are key everywhere. Whatever you see is a key. Whatever you see in a particular system is a key. If you remove it, the system will stop working. So that means that knowledge you have, that skill you have, is very, very important. If you are to be removed, then the system will not work unless they look for a replacement or a spare key. That is another person that can perform the same function you can perform. Therefore, I want you to start looking at yourself. Start looking at your skill as a key to the system you belong to. That system cannot function except you are there. Then let's look at two reasons why people may not be patronizing you enough as you want to. One of the reasons is that those who know your worth have not yet located you. You have not promoted yourself enough. I mean, you have not advertised your knowledge, skill, and experience very well. They don't know you exist. And take for instance, your key can be under your bed, and you'll be looking for everywhere. You have searched everywhere, all the cupboard, all the kitchen cabinet, everywhere. The key cannot announce itself that I'm here, but your key is under the bed. And that means, as long as that key is under the bed and you don't see it, then you cannot use it that day. You have to use a spare key. So, one of the reasons that people are not patronizing you enough is that they don't know you. They don't know you exist. You have not promoted yourself enough. You are sort of hiding. The people that value you have not yet identified you. Once they identify you, when they need you, they have no option but to call on you. Then, the second reason why people are not patronizing you enough is perhaps you are a spare key. And this means that they know you exist, but they are still using some other person that can still perform the same function you can perform. and maybe perhaps the person is better than you, or they have not tried your own hand yet. So that means you may be a spare key. They have already discovered you, but they have not started using you yet. And when the day come that they will use you, they will use you. So all you need to do is to let them know that you exist. Then as a key, what should you do? What should you do as a key? As a key, you should promote yourself very well. Come out of your hiding place. Let your audience discover you. Your audience are people that know your worth, those who know your value, those who need you to solve their problem. They are your audience. Everybody cannot patronize you. Everybody cannot be your audience. It's only few people in the society that are your audience. And when they are able to locate you, then they will use you and they have to pay you for using you. So you need to promote yourself and come out of your hiding place. Let people know you. Let your audience start knowing you. Now I have told you that you need to promote yourself. Somebody may say, okay, now I discover. So what I'm going to do is to run Facebook ad or run Google ads and say, hey, I am a mechanic or I am a carpenter. There are strategies to it. You don't just go and be running ad and say, I am a builder, I am a civil engineer. There is a strategy you can use to promote yourself. So I will teach you that strategy in this course. All you need to do is to click on that link in the description and you get started. Thank you for watching this video and I love to see you there. Bye.